morning, everyone. We are all sitting here today to discuss the post-Commonwealth Games scenario in Indian sporting industry. So, my personal opinion on the topic is that, you know, decking up the city, and you know, we all know that Delhi went through a major revamp through these past few days. And I personally feel that taking up the city is okay, but establishing, as far as the establishment of the sporting culture in India was concerned, I think the Commonwealth Games wasn't able to do that.
Yeah, I agree with Aman. Despite a few controversies, India's great organizer event, multi event sports and Commonwealth Games in India, and UK said after post-Commonwealth Games event which was here in India that these were the best multi event sports Commonwealth Games which was organized by Indian government, and so many countries, despite the Fiji was one of the most countries that was not came to participate that Commonwealth Games, and except Fiji, all of the Commonwealth Games association, which concerned countries, all have participated, and it was a spectacular ending at Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium. I'm agreeing that it was a great event.
Yeah, I agree with Sajid. And because of Commonwealth Games, the image was grown of the India. And as Sakit says about the closing ceremony of the Commonwealth Games, that image was very great, and that day was the big day for India.
I respect all of your points of view, but we can't see only one part that India is unable to create a sports culture, or if the UK government had said something, but we have to see an overall perspective. From an overall perspective, the Commonwealth Games, it comes with a lot of job opportunity. It creates infrastructure in Delhi and all over India. It's true that the budget has exceeds, but at the end, it gives something to India. The all over world appreciate India for its closing ceremony and overall how they treat the Commonwealth Games participating.
I agree totally with you, Gunjan. The Commonwealth Games has given a new dimension to India from the development point of view. Like we have grown up in infrastructure, as you said. Apart from that, the development in the sense that we can see a better India from now, and everybody can see India as a country that can host large budget events. And as well as there are various issues that are taken into consideration due to this Commonwealth Games. Like as we have known that during the Commonwealth Games, transportations, the blue line services of blue line buses have been stopped. And they were saying that after the completion of this game, that those buses will be allowed to come on the road. But as they have seen, the number of accidents has reduced during Commonwealth Games due to the blue line buses. They have decided to permanently stop blue line buses coming on roads. So I think this has given a major dimension to the Indian government, that they can take such steps, not only during such events, that these steps can be this can be initialized, implemented even after such events also, for the overall development of India, overall development of a particular city. So this has given a great shape, and even the security system that was very much criticized, many as Sunidhi has said that some country participated in this game, and I think their concern was okay. From their point of view, it might be right, but India as a whole, they have proved that they can put good amount of security to every citizen, every visitor of any country to work in a country, and they are safe enough to travel and play sports and do anything they want.
Okay. I'm respectful of all your points, but I have something to say about the infrastructure and that and project taken by the Delhi government and the Delhi committee. Actually, there are the organizing committee and the Delhi government has taken 76 projects during this Commonwealth Games, and only 21 projects are related to the Commonwealth Games, as making stadiums, construction, roads, and other infrastructure. So beside, and this now the current issue is about the corruption.
Right.
Okay, and the Indian government leading by Prime Minister Manmohan Singh met a group or a committee regarding this corruption. So they demand the corruption, the committee that formed by the leading by government demanded organizing committee to show all the budget regarding the Commonwealth Games. So I think, yeah, the Commonwealth Games is one of the most expensive Commonwealth Games for all the world. It was more than US Commonwealth Games. The expensive for the Commonwealth Games held in US was $1.6 billion. Okay, and this is much greater than that events.
So I am agreeing with my mom. In India, Commonwealth Games has main impacts on economic growth of India. And India has spent millions of money on Commonwealth Games. And Delhi has got economic profit development, like metro extension, railway, and roads, etc. And it's also improvements on sports and stadium infrastructure.
I respect your opinions, Deepika, Gunjan and Pooja, but I'd like to differ on certain things. I mean, if you look at it, only the outer context as the infrastructure look good. I mean, Commonwealth Games is supposed to be about sports.
Yeah.
And as far as the stadiums are concerned, I think, yes, the stadiums have been put up really well. But what about the equipments that are necessary for the athletes? We all know that most of the equipments were rented and have gone back. We all know that Indian cyclists who have now recently gone for the Asian Games that are going on in China have gone without the proper gear. And my question is that yes, infrastructure is there, but you know, what have they done to make it sustainable? Secondly, as far as benefit, the tourism and all that, all those benefits are concerned, I mean, World Commonwealth Games really a major hit as far as tourism is concerned. We had built around 3,000 bed and breakfast schemes, which went empty. Hotels, five-star hotels like Radisson's did not receive any bookings. So it was a failure in terms of tourism. Traffic, yes, New Line buses were off the roads, but still you have major traffic jams every day. People getting late for home by 3-4 hours. So in terms of traffic as well, it was a failure. Funds in excess of 70,000 crores are still not accounted for, and we don't know what's going to happen to the controversy.
Yeah, I'm agree with you, but there is a first of all tourism. According to the tourism, they are not coming in there is because of the crisis happened in Mumbai.
I think what Aman
this is because of all the security problems.
This is all the corruption and all this is in inner part. But outer part, the image is very successful in Commonwealth Games. So 86% was everyone said that 86% was succeeded, and only 10% is not succeeded because of the 10% is only the beggars are coming up. Actually, beggars are keeping. In other side, but they coming out and they do the same thing before
I think tourism is not sustainable.
Let me come to the conclusion. As far as our discussion, now I want to ask some concluded about the impact of Commonwealth Games in Delhi Games. The impact of Commonwealth Games in India is it increased the GDP of the capital of India, and also it increased the infrastructure of Delhi, and also increase the image of the sports of Indian culture throughout the world.